you ask, how could you get into it? First, get excited because it is fun. Don't let me downplay you by saying it was a, I should have never started. No, that's not right. I enjoyed it. I built thousands and thousands of guitars in my lifetime, mostly custom guitars, regular guitars, touch guitars, whatever. But I would say you take a guitar, and you first off, take an old guitar you really don't want anymore, and just pull it all the way apart and examine it. And then just read the web. It used to be 10 years ago, remember, you could go to the web and couldn't see anything. Today, you could ask anything and they'll answer your question. So I would do that, go to the web, and you'll see a lot of ideas. I'm giving you some ideas just on these little talks I'm doing on the web. I like that. People ask me questions. I like to answer their questions. Building a guitar is something that you want to do because you want it for yourself, not because you're trying to sell it, because that's a little different incentive. I would always have the idea, that's just my own thoughts, and I always had that, was for myself or somebody that I was helping or a band I was building. I would then go to try to find a local luthier to talk to, and I would do that. There's luthiers in every town. Go to the guitar shops and they'll tell you who they are because they usually work on their guitars. So go to a guitar shop, wherever you can find it, whatever one it is, and I'll bet you'll find somebody who'll say, oh, yeah, old John Blow, go over there. He does guitars, sets them up, builds them. And most of those people are really friendly. They'll talk to you. They'll see a kid or a, I don't care if you're 12 or if you're 90. They'll see somebody that's trying to do something they did once and they'll want to give them their advice. That'd be the first thing. Then the second thing would be to just study out things like I put up there sometimes, what a neck is about. We build a tensioner. I came up with a tension-free neck because I couldn't get the sound out of the upper fets of the guitar that I wanted on the touch system. So I had to build a better resonating neck that vibrated and the strings didn't kill it by the tension of the strings on the end of the neck. So my thing is simple. Make it exciting. Do it because you want to build something better. Do it because you want something that you love to play. And find good reasons. Even add in there that maybe I'll build a guitar and the girls be so impressed, they'll join me in a band and I'll go play all over the world with a band of girls. Well, I could have been so lucky. But anyway, I'm just telling you, that's the way to do it. Get excited, build your first, go to luthiers to find out some of the ideas, go to the web, look up old guys like old Dave Bunker, guys, 60 years of patents and building and blah, 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 blah. And just do it that way. And you'll find a great thing to do. You'll have fun. You'll love that guitar when you're done. And you'll learn a lot about carpentry, about stress, about music, about all kinds of things. So thanks for asking. Hey, that's a nice question. I wish somebody asked me that years about 65 or 70 or 80 years. I don't know how long ago. Anyway, a long time ago. Thanks a lot. Thanks for asking.